Welcome to Let's Play Gone Home Blind. I am the RPG Chick. This is going to be another short game. I'm expecting we'll be done in like, I don't know, 8 episodes or maybe less. Just finished playing Event Zero, and now I'm playing this. Thanks to... what these guys written down? Aaron Hopkinson, I'm going by memory, Josh Aronson, Meerkat, and Sam White, in no particular order. Patreon supporters, guys, thank you very much. So you're going to be able to see this about a week or so earlier than anyone else, as my way of saying thanks. If anyone's interested in donating to my Patreon, you can check the link in the description. It is not required, and, you know, it's just a, it's up to you. It's like a little tip jar, if you will. That's all. So this game came out in 2013 for PC, Windows, and, believe it or not, 2016 for Xbox and PlayStation. I'm guessing PlayStation 4? Xbox One? It's a short game of exploration. All I know about it, I'm playing pretty much completely blind, all I know is about it is you're a young woman who's come home and your parents, who are supposed to be there, are not there, and why? And you're supposed to check out things in the house, and that's it. From what I've heard, there are no jump scares, there's not really anything scary. Might be a little scary, creepy mood, which will definitely affect me nonetheless, because I'm a wimp when it comes to stuff like this. So, options. Graphics, I have everything up, as you can see. Controls, mouse sensitivity, like, I already have mouse acceleration, so that kind of... I guess maybe if I turn that off, but instead I decided to slide that down, that was fine. So yes, I am playing, as you can tell by the pointer, I'm playing on PC. I've reduced the volume so you can hear me over stuff. All this stuff, I don't feel like I want to disable stuff. This is pretty much the default. The way it comes up was fine. And I don't know what the overlay text is. You know what, let's enable it and see what it is. Overlay text. And what are we overlaying? Anyway, so I've played a very small amount. I picked up like a duck, like a toy duck, a rubber duck or something like that. And I threw it and practiced picking up and throwing it. And that's it. That's all I really did. So, new game. Stuff. Oh, we got these modifiers too. I guess if you want to go through another playthrough, I don't know. I'm not doing any of this stuff. The lights can stay off. I do want the map. I would like to be able to unlock doors. So I don't want to make it too easy. I want to hear the voice diaries, and I don't want to hear commentary. So that's definitely commentary, second playthrough at least. The Fullbright Company presents a phone call.
Hi, Mom. So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so, love you. See you soon. Bye.
Bye. Something tells me she wouldn't have got picked up. Because who knows where her parents are. June 7th, 1995, 1:15 a.m. Interesting how it's placed at this time. The game was released in 2013. So there's my baggage. We got crouch. That was just a toggle. We don't have to hold it down. These are our items. So that's us. We were born in 73. And now it's, what, 95? So she's 22. That's my passport. I got it to go on my Europe trip. By the way, guys, I read all the things. So if you don't want to hear someone read all the things, I apologize. This may not be for you. So her name's Caitlin Greenbrier. This is my boarding pass back from my year in Europe. Oh. She was in Amsterdam. Transferred to Cincinnati, now we're in Portland. Portland, Oregon? Doesn't say. Map, journals, press. Okay, that's if there's something there, okay. Whoa. I just think I turned the sensitivity down. Grab cup. So you can rotate the cup. There's nothing inside the cup. You can throw the cup. Christmas dock. You know what I'm gonna do? Turn that off. All right, now I need to. Increase that a little bit. That should hopefully not be good old Christmas duck now it says. So if we duck. House key. That's why we duck. Lamp. Spare key that was hidden under old Christmas dock. Okay. Oh wait. Katie, I'm sorry I can't be there to see you, but it is impossible. Please, please don't go digging around trying to find out where I am. I don't want anyone to know. We'll see each other again someday. Don't be worried. I love you, Sam. Sam. Is Sam one of her parents? Her father? Or mother, Samantha? Wellspring Movers. They moved? Terrence Greenbrier. 1880. Whoa. Don't do that. Destination 1 Arbor Hill. We got boxes. Childbed, overweight library office. 2 television sets. Continued unattached.
Dear Katie.
Whoops.
So much has changed. Even just since you've been away. We moved into this house. I'm in a new school. And my big sister being gone for a year doesn't make it any easier. It doesn't feel real. But I'm not gonna let it faze me. I used to tell you everything, and if I can't do it in person, because you're off gallivanting around who knows where, I'll tell it to this journal. Just like I was talking to you.
So they just moved here? When we move over something like that, it drags. That's interesting. I'm telling you, that the atmospheric sounds are crazy here. Oh, I want to go...
Dear Katie, so much has changed. Even just since you've been away. We moved into this house. I'm in a new school. And my big sister being gone for a year doesn't make it any easier.
Can't stop it?
Mm. It doesn't feel real. But I'm not gonna let it faze me. I used to tell you everything, and if I can't do it in person, because you're off gallivanting around who knows where, I'll tell it to this journal. Just like I was talking to you.
All right. Really unnerved about how slow the mouse goes. Kind of wish that was an option we could turn off. Now we can zoom in as well. Yep, on things. I would look at these, you know, these letters, but I can't. Author magazine. Oh, so this is the... This is the text over... whatever. Text overlay. Stephen King critiques the art of... So you can... I gotta turn that off, actually. Let's... Gameplay? Sound? Language. Because we can read that. Freelancing tips and tricks from the pros. February 1995, so this is new. Okay, someone... One of our parents is an author. Or a sister. Sparkle! Oh, I could put it back neatly like that. Okay. That should help, actually. Band-aids. More band-aids. Hooray for toilet paper! Tippy for your bunghole. Maybe I should close these doors? I don't want to have to hide in here. I don't want this to be like in like what amnesia, right? Where you hide. Janice Greenbrier, senior conservationist. Forestry Service. Cool. Over the Alps. A novel traveling game. I like that we can put things back and not just clumsily throw them. So they didn't finish moving in here. Oh, wait, what's that? Have a doggone cool 17th birthday. Happy birthday, Sam. Uncle Harvey. And this thunder's so loud. I wonder if anything else could be sticking out from it. No? No. So, Sam. Who's Sam? Father? Wait, Sam? That's a 17th birthday. So there's Katie, Sam, and Janice. 1. We might be the parents. I don't even know. Boone County telephone directory. Dear Jan, it's so good to hear from you again. All this new house business sounds like quite the adventure. Remember the little dorm room we shared freshman year? When we were miserable, fantasizing about our dream homes, I always said I wanted a mansion. You said you just wanted a house in the woods. Look who got both. Somebody up there likes you. I could use some of that magic. Send me some lotto numbers. I'll play them. Seriously. But I shouldn't be complaining about this good old split level we've had since Bob got transferred to Winnipeg. We just got new vinyl siding. Goody. Jealous yet? Let me know if you ever want to trade places. So how are the girls doing? Has Katie left on her big European adventure yet? Speaking of jealous, right back soon. I miss you, Rumi. Carol. Okay, so Jan is the mother. So it's just that letter. Hold on a second. Yeah, that's the same. Okay. Books. Oh, the Bible. Nothing down in there. Pick up one of my trophies. Regional track and field finals, April 21st, 1990, so 5 years ago when she was 17. Caitlin Greenbrier, that's us. I can't actually look. I can only turn it. Hecho in Mexico. Pick up my old track trophy. So that's a... This is a trophy and this is a track trophy. 1981 Girls Long Jump Event, Caitlin Greenbrier, first place. I don't think there's anything down in there, no. Okay, so this game, you're really supposed to interact with everything. So that door... that door. Or upstairs. I'm not going upstairs yet. Itinerary. Katie's departure, 7694. 1210 to Amsterdam. So, what happened? Well, Katie was gone. Phone. Play message. Read note. Sam, Daniel from the old neighborhood called. He wants to come see the new house. Call him back. Mom, Daniel is a total weirdo. The only reason I ever hung out with him in the first place is he had a Nintendo when we were little. So Sam must be my brother.
Sam. Sam. Hello? Sam! Sam, where are you? Really? I need to talk to you. Please be there.
Hi, Mom. So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in the midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so, love you. See you soon. Bye.
Oh, Sam is a girl. So Sam's a girl. And then we got our father. And our mother. I'm so bad with names. There's no sprint. I'm instinctively trying to sprint. Our mother is Janice. We are here. Hey, it's one of the postcards I sent. Paris. 8294. Hey, hi Mom, Dad, it's Sam. I'm in Paris. I have done many Parisian things, including... Can't close that door. I don't like that. Including eating le petit déjeuner and wearing a beret. I'm going to have lots of film to develop when I get back. Sam, I'm bringing you back something from the Shakespeare Book Company since you are my favorite sister. Love you all, Katie. Weird. That's the new address. Welcome, new student. We hope that you're as excited about your first day at Goodfellow High School as we are. Please be sure to bring the following with you on your first day of classes so that you can get right into the swing of things. One sturdy folder with pockets for each of your six class periods. One line notebook per period. Blah, blah, blah. I got rid of all this. Six pens, colored pencils, combination lock. Nutritious lunch, or $2.50 for lunch. A positive attitude. That's not crossed out. Please remember to get plenty of sleep the night before and be ready for the first bell to ring at 8 a.m. See you soon, and again, welcome Beth Valence, principal.
Oh my god, you are so lucky you finished high school before we moved into this house. So, it's the first day of school, and there I am, introducing myself to the class. And I say that I just moved into the house on Arbor Hill. All of a sudden, every kid in the room turns and just stares like I suddenly transformed into a mutant. I just stood there, wishing pretty hard for a rewind button. Because now maybe nobody knows my name, but they all know who I am. The Psycho House Girl. Great.
Okay, Psycho House Girl. TV's on. Great. Oh. Yeah, that must work so great. Electrical inspection form for Terrence. Okay, that's our father then, Terrence. Do we meet legal codes? Yes. Are there deficiencies which needs correcting? Unclear. Wiring in house is technically up to safety and amperage requirements. However, multiple layers of wiring have been added into structure over the last 100 years. System is frequently unpredictable. Lights blink out for no apparent reason. Pressure on floorboards and door frames disrupts circuits wired directly behind the surface. Properly reworking the electrical system would be highly destructive to the walls, floor, and fixtures of the structure. After discussion with Mr. Greenbrier, since there are no current safety concerns, issues will not be addressed. Killing of JFK, a theory. You've seen the movie Discover the Truth. An important new look at the circumstances surrounding one of the greatest tragedies of our time. A thrilling theory. I couldn't put this book down. S. O'Reilly. Enter combination. Very loud. Right, so we need a combination. Here's our writer. John Russell opened his eyes and saw them, the stars, twinkling as if he were lying on the grass in his family's yard in Massachusetts, even though that place was a million miles away. No, he blinked the sleep from his eyes, looking through the carbon-reinforced safety glass of the space station Archimedes. Yes, he was a long way from home, but the future needed him. John Russell's head swam. He felt incredibly drunk. Despite not having touched a drop in hours, he vomited onto his feet, his bare feet. He stared for a moment, processing his sick, flecked toenails, scanning up his bare shins, bare knees. He was completely naked. He looked up and met the eyes of a gorgeous blonde woman wearing a tight polymer fiber tunic. The fabric that strained at the seams seems to contain her generous bosom was emblazoned with the phrase Matter Transference Operator. Then he passed out. John Russell had crossed the gap in time. Only messages had passed Biafra. But now, and man, they needed him, now more than ever. Changing the past was no longer good enough. The instructions from the Council had been clear. What to procure, what to construct from it, how to assemble it. So he made the machine, how to transport it, him bolt. How to transport him bodily across time, and now he stood. Thought I heard something, I wasn't sure. There on the bridge of the starship Archimedes, comma, end of the vessel, because only he who had saved the Predisnet's life twice before could helm the Neve crew to their destiny. Fate of the galaxy. Yeah, you needed to keep working on that. You can do better. What if JFK wasn't JFK? Early spaceflight utopia. Am I in the way of the drawer opening? Every sound is driving me insane here. Terrence Greenbrier. A letter hidden under the, like a fake panel. Dear Terrence, I write on what I hope and imagine is a joyous occasion. News reaches me that you are newly married to a wonderful young woman. I have had more than a little time to consider my past and my family, and my thoughts have often lingered on your development and welfare in the 10 years since we last met. Your marriage gives me much reassurance in this regard. You are always welcome on Arbor Hills. I will understand if you feel you cannot accept this invitation. Yours very sincerely, Oscar Mesa. Is it like his therapist or something? That's cool, we found a hidden thing. Alright, what's in here?